spaceship. Get out of the 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 spaceship.
Thank you. Too much, but she went to get me to go. oyster-like style. Yes, we are most time out here maybe though. All the mess is up, they get into my makeup a lot of times if they don't have mess. Oh, they put on my long dresses and my heels and their, maybe they'll follow pat and they'll make mustache and then they'll put lipstick, the boys will wear the lipstick.
He's 15, he likes to go swimming.
Thank you. Great thing to take them, of course, to the minute. tub.
Now, since you live quite close to the railroad track, they operated manually at that time.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They're what they call shanties. Little buildings called shanties. About 5 foot square. There'd be a man in that around the clock, 8 hours.
Look back at some of the people who perform certain functions then that are gone to us today, like the blacksmith, for example.
Well, down on Grand Street, there was a blacksmith shop owned by Tom McGann.
It seems that you could divide Concord up into these different sections.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
that's for sure. The back of the depot, which encompassed the area I told you about. And then, as you went up Subby Road and got beyond the brook, Harrington Brook right there, just before you get to Riverdale, that whole area up there was called Hubbardville. There was a man by the name of Hubbardville. Used to live up there.
Then there were people within the town.
Thank you.
Cal NEH American English Dialect Recordings Collection, produced with funding from the National Endowment for the Humanities.
I went to the University of Denver.
Okay. And what did you do there?
Well, I went there as a young kid from Denver Scholarship.
What kind of a scholarship?
Church Scholarship, 18. But because he was Southerner,
Engineer department, 22 engineer. truck and bring them around.
I take the one wheel engineer to one mine, I take another wheel to the other mine, and if they call me in to come bring them in, if they call me up in my office and I go get them, bring them in, then when it's a 4-tour equipment time, I make a 4 trips to take everybody home before it's equipment. I do my job. So one day I start eating dinner, and Jay Palovir, he said to me, Joe,
that's it.
No.
Thank you.